I want to use a little piece of the genome to identify things. From my standpoint, genomics is going into the genome of anything, a rabbit, you, a lettuce plant, I don't care who it is, and taking out a little 650 base pair segment that we get the same segment from each of these different species. And we discover that that little 650 base pair segment is a little bit different from each species to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next. So if you have that little piece, that one little word, it's like having a collection of all the license plates on all the cars in the world. So all you got to do is give me the license plate and I can say, ah, that's a, and now we know what it is, because I look it up in a registry where the license plates are registered. So really what I'm after is the license plate that goes with the species. Because right now, you and everybody else is basically what I call bio-illiterate, okay? The analogy again is, you were taught how to read in second grade, so you're literate. And so you use that for everything. But nobody taught you how to walk up to an ant on the pavement, know who the ant is. Or when you eat some little green thing, what is it? Or you eat a, you bite into a McDonald's hamburger, is it really a cow? Or is it a horse? Or is it a chicken? Or is it a pig all mixed together? Well, you have no way of doing that. We can't teach you that when you're in second grade. But if I give you this when you're in second grade, then you can read the biodiversity that's around you, okay? That's what we're talking about. So there are gadgeteers out there actually making and inventing this. It's going through various evolutionary steps. Right now, it's still, you're talking about several hundred dollars for something that can do something like that. And it's not easily reusable, and it requires reagents and things like that. But it's all headed towards the simple, cheap, throwaway, reusable gadget, all right? What I see happening is that you're standing in southern Venezuela, and a caterpillar just stings your hand, and you want to know, should I worry about that? Or should I, it's just pain, and who cares, you know? And so you kill the caterpillar, or you get a piece of him, and you get it on your thing, and it goes to through a wireless world, it goes to a central system. And the system says back to you, we don't have that barcode. Where are you? And you push a button on your iPhone or whatever you have that's the equivalent of that, and it registers then where that barcode came from, and then it says to you, and what does it look like? So you take your iPhone camera and you go click and you take a photograph of it, and then that's in the thing. So now they have a photograph, they have the barcode, they have a locality. From the photograph, it's probably possible to say, ah, that was a caterpillar. That wasn't a snail. That wasn't a mouse. And so I can predict that there'll be a system of taxonomists out there who effectively be people who look at that photograph and say, oh, that's another species of Hylesia and the Saturniidae. And so now we have a Latin name that goes with it. It might not be a described species of Hylesia, but at least it's in that genus Hylesia. And then it will say to you, are you willing to collect it for us? And often you would say, no, I'm a tourist. I don't have time to do that. But if you're a scientist or somebody who really cares, an agricultural worker or whatever, then you might collect it and send it to some central place. So you gradually build the library by users. And if you've got 8 billion people all doing that, you can see where the library could grow very quickly, especially around the things that people come in contact with.